Y'all know this party gonna get turned out when Uncle Al is in the high. Uncle Al's murder.
The death of Uncle Al, I mean, that was a difficult day for Miami as well as myself.
To this day.
It's something that I think touched everybody in Miami.
And Al just meant so much to everybody in the community. And I remember, you know, probably a few days before he died, he was like, look, man, you gotta keep this music in this, you gotta keep this thing going for us. This is what we started.
And Al was somebody that no matter, you know, where you're from, if you were Cuban, if you were Haitian, if you were white, pink, purple, black, and you, but as long as you represented Miami, he embraced it. I think he was someone that was a pioneer and was way ahead of his time, especially the way that he set up radio stations and the way he would try to touch the neighborhoods and the way he tried to change Miami.
And, you know, what he did for the music scene out here in Miami just was, you know what I mean, priceless.
He is Miami. You know what I'm saying? Like, he is Miami. He embodies everything about this city.
I think Al's someone that's gonna always live on the legacy of what Miami is.
He was like a real inspiration to me, you know, because there have always been times where I'm like, man, I'm fed up doing music with this whole thing, because it's just too much BS in the game. But then, you know, when Al died, you know, he leaves with a legacy. And that's one thing. When you die, you want to leave people with something that they will always talk about. And when people say peace in the hood, that's Al's legacy. And that will never end until there is peace in the hood.
Rest in peace is something that definitely touched all of us. And we'll forever carry on the Uncle Al legacy.